Time is short, so I'll be brief. With the successful breakout from Normandy by our troops, the Nazis are quickly falling back to their border. Hitler knows that France has been lost, and we've intercepted a communique ordering Dietrich von Choltitz, the general in charge of Paris, to burn the capital before the Allies get there. Apparently, though, Choltitz is having second thoughts about going down in history as the man who extinguished the City of Lights, and the Swedish Consul General has stepped in to broker a ceasefire. Unfortunately, we can't be sure all the junior officers will go along with disobeying a direct order from the Führer, and there are reports of explosives being distributed to key locations around the city. Paris has survived for over 4 years under Nazi occupation. It would be horrible for it to be destroyed now, on the eve of its liberation. It's time for you to go home, Manon. Good luck.
Thank you. Fine.
Move.
Thank you. Thank you. Fighting was fierce as Allied troops battled house to house and town to town in the days following the invasion. Despite heavy casualties, the Allies soon had the upper hand. The Nazi war effort was beginning to collapse. This news swept Paris, where the city erupted as everyday citizens joined with the resistance in rising up against their Nazi occupiers. Fear and anguish turned to joy and elation as the last German forces evacuated and the first Allied tanks appeared. What had seemed impossible to even dare think in the darkest days of the Blitzkrieg had unbelievably come true. We'll be right back.